and Thrones. Today we're going to be talking about Moog One Hate. Moog One Hate. I'm Pure Ambient Drone. This is my channel where I talk about synthesizers. And if you want to keep up with all of my synth adventures, hit the subscribe button right now. Well, what do I mean by Moog One Hate? Well, I got to tell you guys, I've gotten a lot of hate over complaining about the price of the Moog One. Because I feel that $8,000 for a new synthesizer in today's technological world is too much money. I've got people actually calling me hateful names, okay? Now here's what's remarkable about the whole thing, is that I have read comments where people are actually attacking me as a human being, okay? Attacking my character, attacking my synth abilities, you name it. They know nothing about me, okay? But they're attacking me, and I'm a human being, so that they can defend a synthesizer. Does that make any sense whatsoever to anyone that a human being would trash another human being and get personal about it over a machine? This is the world that we live in now. But I stand by my claim that the Moog One is too much money for today's technology. And, you know, I don't think people are really watching the videos as I'm discussing them and getting the clear picture that what I'm saying is we don't live in 1980, we don't live in 1990, we don't even live in the 2000s. We live in an era now where technology is so advanced that there are so many things that we can do and we can mass produce on such a level. And you know, people are saying things like, well, you know, Moog outsources all of their stuff to the United States. Listen, it does not cost them that kind of money to make a synthesizer, okay? You can buy cars and mopeds and little motorcycles and things like that and home stereo systems and all kind of stuff that's made in America, right? I get it. But this synthesizer isn't so special, isn't so absolutely out of this world that it's going to cost $8,000 out of my pocket, and people justify that. It cannot be justified. But anyway, I got a lot of hate on that, and I can't believe that people would rather hate on a human being in defense of a machine as if they had stock in Moog Industries or something, you know, like maybe they work for Moog. I don't know. Maybe they were people that worked for Moog that left those comments. That's a possibility, right? But, you know, it's my opinion. This is my channel where I talk about my synth adventures. And no, I'm not upset because I can't afford one of the Moog ones. I actually can, but I don't want to afford it. That's the whole thing. I don't want to dish out $8,000. You know what I'm saying? And I know a lot of other synth drones out there in the world that don't want to dish out $8,000 for one synthesizer. You could do a lot of stuff with your setup at home or in your studio with $8,000. You could actually get a lot of things done with $8,000, okay? So keeping the personal attacks aside, okay, and keeping your comments nice and clean and not hateful, please leave one and discuss this with me. I could be wrong about it, right? I haven't heard the thing, and I'm not knocking the synthesizer. You know what I'm saying? But honestly, I don't care if this thing gives me a ticket to the moon and back, if it comes with one of those. I'm still not going to pay $8,000 for a synthesizer. I would rather use the gear that I already have, which I think is adequate, okay? I just don't think that this thing is going to do $8,000 worth of composing, okay, in my studio. I don't think I need to spend that kind of money to get that kind of sound. But again, I have not heard the synthesizer, and, you know, again, I am not attacking the synthesizer's abilities. I'm attacking the price tag. It's a lot of money, $8,000, you know, and a lot of the people that are hating on my videos, they can't afford it either, and they're not going to buy one of these things. I'd be shocked if any of these people who said these nasty, mean, vile things about me, okay, could actually afford one of these, and if they could, they would actually go out and buy one for themselves. I just don't think they're going to do it. I mean, maybe one or two might, I don't know. But I think the majority of us watching these videos, we're not going to go out and buy this $8,000 synthesizer. We know what market Moog is marketing for with this synth. Moog is going for the upper wealthy musician who can afford this kind of stuff, who wants to be one of the first ones to get one. But now listen, if Moog wants to send me one of these synthesizers and let me play with it and let me demo it for you guys, I would love that too. Hint, hint, Moog. It might change my mind. I don't know. I haven't seen it yet. So I'm conceding to the fact that I have not seen or touched the synthesizer yet or heard it. I get it, guys, but come on, man, $8,000 for a synthesizer. Come on, guys, get real. You guys know that that's too much money. Anyway, I love all of you guys. Subscribe if you haven't already done so. I love all my synth drones out there. Leave a nice comment. Leave a disagreeing comment if you want, but be nice. Do not attack me or anyone else on this channel. Keep calm. Synth on.